Vivaldi was right. The seasons are different. And the things you do in the winter are not always the same as the things you do in the summer. My friend, the artist Giovanni Casadei, visits us every summer in Ocean City and paints the seashore. But in the cold of the winter, he stays inside a studio and works on still life.
I have a very different experience when I paint still life and landscapes. It's not just because it's the season changing, so in the winter time inside, but also because the still life, they get born from a different source. When I do the landscapes, I go in nature, immersed in the sunlight. I choose my subject matter according to what I see. I cannot change anything. When I do still life, the feeling that I have inside is going to be the inspiration how to set up this still life. So this still life is not there yet. But my feelings is going to tell me, okay, today I want to do a still life near the window. These are the objects that I'm going to choose. And accordingly to my feelings, I'm going to actually put the object together. And through that process, I paint a still life. So the still life process is a much more intimate and inner process that starts with me, you know, starts with my feelings. Versus the landscaping, producing the feeling that I want to express. This is a Great Dane. I don't know if you know anything about, but they're big like this, you know, from the floor, and their head is like this. My collection of objects is random. Usually I buy them in flea markets or thrift shops. I get attracted to an object. The object you see behind me, this one over here, I bought for $5. As soon as I saw it, I have to have it. Because I could see a potential connection that I can make in my studio. I've been working in this studio for 20 years. I know the light in my studio, I know the environment, and I can see an object in this environment, even though it's not yet in that environment. I have a lot of dry flowers, flowers that, you know, I bought for decorating the house and then painted a little bit. And then dry them. I have some gourds that I dried. I have silver objects, some brass objects, some copper, and some a lot of glasses and ceramics. It's just because I like those objects. My aunt gave this dog to my mother for a wedding present. So I grew up with this dog on the dining room table. It was always present for all my life in Rome. When my mother moved to Scotland, she told me to take anything that I wanted, and I packed the dog and I brought it to the United States. I really like to introduce this dog in my still life because I have a sentimental attachment to it.
Does he have a name?
No, I didn't give him a name for some reason. I never thought about that.
Was he considered a family pet?
Well, no, but it was always there. You know, it was just always there. It's a connection for me to my childhood and connection to Rome. Usually when I set up a still life, I make multiple paintings of the same still life. It takes me a long time to set it up, and I leave it there in my studio maybe for months and months. I have my tables on wheels so I can roll them from one side of the room to another side of the room where the light changes. And I can put it next to the bay window, away from the bay window. I can turn them, I can go around them. If a still life is quite small, usually it resolves itself within a few hours of painting. A lot of my still lifes are still a la prima approach. Some of them are more introspective and meditative, so it requires more time to do it. And I use 2-3 sittings. I have 5 windows in my studio. They're facing north. It's a great advantage to have a north light studio. The light is pretty much constant. It doesn't change the temperature and doesn't change too much of intensity. So you have at least 4 or 5 hours of constant light to work. Changes are very minor, so you can get used to it. And the next day you will have the same situation and so forth. My attitude in painting landscapes is completely different. I know the fleeting moment that is going to happen at the time. I know that the certain kind of intensity of color is not going to be there in probably half an hour. The landscapes, for me, it's a collection of different moments. Still life has more this kind of stillness of a certain moment. That moment is not going to change. Those objects are not going to move anywhere. You know, there are no clouds or waves coming in. It's a very different experience in that regard. Being immersed in the light outside in the landscape, it's a completely different than being in the studio.
The way you were describing the differences between the two makes me almost think that the landscapes are like life and the still lifes are almost like death. And you think of the French term for still life, nature mort, which means what, dead nature?
Well, in Italian it's also natura morta, which is dead nature. Well, I would say instead of death, for me the still life, it's a moment of reflection. You know, it's more introspective, more meditative. My mood is different when I paint a still life. Outside, I feel the joy of the sunlight and everything is moving, the wind, the perfumes and the sounds of birds, you know, people talking, much higher, happier energy. And inside is a different experience. It's more sometimes melancholic.
Well, never fear, my friend, for today is Memorial Day. The sun is shining, the birds are singing, the mama turtles are coming out of the marsh, and soon you will return to your summer paradise with us in Ocean City.
We're always happy, life's for living, yeah, that's our philosophy.